Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And today we're going to be taking a look at the data that we collected in the last video. So if you haven't already seen the last video, make sure you go and watch that before you watch this one, or this one will not make any sense to you. So basically what I have here is I've opened up moving.csv and boot.csv. And we're going to go ahead and take a look at moving.csv first, because that one is where I was moving the mouse. And I thought that one would be a little bit easier to take a look at. So what the analyzer does is it breaks each packet up with a packet ID. So here you can see every 7 bytes is one packet, and then there's a delay, and then you get another 7 bytes and a delay again, and then it just keeps going on and on and on. What I did is I turned it into a row in this sheet, and so each of these rows represents one of those packets. And the next thing we have to do is figure out what each of these bytes actually mean. So I started taking some guesses. I put all the guesses as the table headers. So for example, let's take a look at this one. This one I think is representing whether we're moving the mouse or not. So most of the time it's a 0-3, but then it turns into an 83 when you actually move the mouse. So you can see right here, they're all zeros and that's showing up as threes. And then the moment there was something that the sensor detected, that became an 83. This is some kind of a signal to the microcontroller that some action has happened. So we're gonna go ahead and make note of that. And then the next one is not changing. I'm not seeing any changes on this row. So we're just gonna leave that alone. The next two, I think, represent a number. So it's a 16-bit number. And the next two are the same, 16-bit number. And then the last one isn't doing anything. It's just always 10. So I took a guess that this is the low byte and this is the high byte. And I could be wrong here, but that's, we're just gonna take a guess and see what happens. And the same thing here, low and high. And one of these represent the X channel and one represents the Y channel. So next I combined two, the low and the high, into a 16-bit value. Same thing for the y-axis, and then I converted to a signed integer. So this one I think represents dx, and this one represents dy. And the reason I think it's a delta x and a delta y is because these numbers are very small, so I think they add up together to represent an absolute value of where the mouse is. So if you scroll down, you'll see these numbers do change. So when I'm moving the mouse, they're changing. So that's a good sign. The next two columns here, I'm basically just adding up all the values. So this is the absolute position in X. This is the absolute position in Y. And then last thing I did is I actually plotted those out on the bottom to see if the plot actually looks correct. And we'll see right here that the plot does look correct. So blue is the X and orange is the Y. So you can see the Y starts moving first, and it's oscillating up and down like I was moving the mouse. And the X is also oscillating a little bit less, but it is oscillating. So it actually does look pretty good to me, but we won't know for sure until we put it in a mouse and actually try to move a cursor with it. But that won't be in this video. This video is just to figure out if we can understand the data. Okay, lastly, we have the boot.csv. Now this one was pretty amazing to me because this has over 17,000 fields or 17,000 bytes before we ever get into that moving mode. So that means that the microcontroller is sending the sensor 14,000 commands before it's initialized, which is a lot. Normally there's only like 50 to 100 bytes, but this sensor requires a lot more. I think it may be uploading some kind of a firmware to the sensor, because I couldn't find a datasheet on the sensor, so I can't know for sure. But in theory, if we replayed all this back to the sensor, it would work. But I don't think that makes any sense to do. I think for this series, I'm gonna go ahead and find a sensor that we can get a datasheet for and know how to use the registers so that we get a nice finished board at the end that works. That's pretty much it for this video. I'm gonna keep it short. Thank you for watching. If you like this kind of video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so I can continue making these kinds of videos for you. And I hope to see you back next time. Thank you. Bye.